So today's topic is defibrillator. So before going into the fine details of defibrillator, let me read out what is fibrillation, that is especially ventricular fibrillation. Ventricular fibrillation is a serious cardiac emergency resulting from asynchronous contraction of heart muscle. So we have shown you the PQRS waveform already, the pattern. If there is some distance in the pattern, that means a ventricular fibrillation has been occurred. Okay, this fibrillation leads to loss of cardiac output. Cardiac output means the ECG waveform is not normal, and irreversible brain damage or death, sometimes death also. Sometimes patient may go to coma if not reversed within 5 minutes of onset. That means we have only 5 minutes right from the cardiac arrest. Within that 5 minutes we should take care of the patient. We should do defibrillation and other medical attention. If not, the patient may die. So ventricular fibrillation can be converted into more efficient rhythm by applying a high energy shock. So we have to give a high energy shock. Some 80% of the cases have survived because this first, we can call this as a first aid also. High energy shock to the heart. This sudden surge across the heart cause all muscle fibers to contract. So when we give a surge, the heart muscles will contract, all the muscles in different conditions. They will try to converge at the same level. The sudden surge across the heart causes all muscle fibers to contract simultaneously. Possibly, the fibers may then respond to normal physiological intrinsic pulse. So, we are giving a shock, so all the fibers are contracted, and then all the activities of the heart starts functioning normally. So this is the basic idea of fibrillation and defibrillation. So for defibrillator, we should give a shock. Now we will see how electronics, especially the use of capacitor, because plus two students, NCERT students, one of the application they have specified is how the capacitor is used in defibrillation. As far as electronics student or instrumentation student, they should know the working principle of the circuit diagram. So let us see how it works. Okay. So fibrillation is the problem or cardiac, the pulse, the ECG waveform is not steady. It's fibrillation. So we have to do defibrillation. So this circuit is nothing but a defibrillator. So we have 230 volts, 50 hertz AC. You have an auto transformer. You may ask why the 230 volts is not directly given to the step-up transformer, because the 230 volts may increase or decrease, and it is always roughly around 230 volts. But if you use an auto transformer, you can change the potential anywhere between 0 to 230. Therefore, suppose if I need 100 volts, yes, it's possible. 100 volts AC, 150 volts AC, anything. So using this auto transformer, we can set the AC voltage. That's the primary functioning of this auto transformer. The voltage we are setting can be seen through the voltmeter, usually moving iron instrument. Okay, then it is stepped up. Suppose if you maintain this as 100, so this will be stepped up, that 100 volts. So it is always will be in 100 volts. Okay, now this is stepped up, it's a step up transformer. We have a secondary AC at this point. RS is the series resistance. Diode, you know, diode is forward, when plus minus diode is forward bias, it will charge the capacitor. Reverse direction, there is it will not affect the these circuits. That's why we put a diode. If you don't put a diode, the reverse side also some problem, arcing may occur. So this is a protection device. And moreover, the diode, you all know that it converts AC into DC. Okay, it's basically an half-wave rectifier. So assume in forward bias, if this is short, the charging time tau is approximately equal to RC. So the capacitor charges smoothly. That time constant is defined by R and C. So to produce a shock, we need roughly 2 kilovolts in a short span of time. So the capacitance value is 10 microfarad to 50 microfarad. It can be anywhere in this value. But the important point you have to observe is the voltage gradient. Since we require 2 kilovolts, at least the capacitor voltage rating should be twice of that value. That means 2K means roughly you can put 4K. So now I recommend for 5K. If you ask whether I can put 10K or whatever, very, very good. You can, higher rating, higher voltage rating is always advisable. So you can put 5 kilovolts rating of the capacitor. So what happens is the capacitor charges. So when you want to apply to the patient, so these two are electrodes. So these two electrodes are pressed on the chest of the patient. So the switch is initially connected here for normal charging, but when you apply for the shock for the patient, then you have to connect the switch here. That means this portion is disconnected and it gets connected here. So the voltage here starts discharging through this capacitance L. You all know that L, inductance will oppose any current variations. That's why we have included inductance. And this is one electrode, another electrode. These two electrodes are placed over the chest. The area of the plates is 9 centimeters, so roughly 9 are 81 centimeter square area, and this plates will have a resistance in between 50 ohms to 100 ohms. That depends. So we know the area, that means we have the resistance. So this can be considered as 50 to 100 ohms, here also 50 to 100 ohms, and the body resistance. Body means you are pressing over the chest. So the body resistance, but it is highly negligible, but that also should be included for analysis. So these two electrodes are placed over the chest, especially near to the heart. Placed over the heart. And there is a key. This is the switch. There is usually, it will be kept at the foot. So when you press, it connects here and discharges. This voltage across the capacitor is discharged through the patient and to the ground. Now you must know what is the waveform. So it is roughly, the maximum voltage slowly rises at zero, it slowly rises to 2 kilovolts. This is the required voltage, and slowly decreases, and finally it will become zero. And this should happen within 10 milliseconds. The time duration is 10 milliseconds. So 1 second, you know, 1 second is equal to 1000 milliseconds. Okay? 1 second is equal to 1000 milliseconds. Now this time duration is 10 milliseconds. So we need 10 milliseconds. So this is 10 milliseconds by 1000 into 1 second. So that is 0.01 second. 1 second, you know, this is 1 second. So this is divided by 1000, in that you are taking 10 divisions, that is 0.01 second. So this is the shock that we are giving to the patient who has suffered cardiac arrest. Okay. So I told everything, this is the charging part. So first they will press, then release, off, press, release. That means during release, first they will press because charge discharged, then they will release and the connection will go like this. It charges. Once again they press, they release the energy to the patient. Likewise, you have to, it is not continuously press, then release, then once again press, release, because the voltage across the capacitor, when it gets discharged completely, once again it has to be charged up. Okay, so it will charge very soon. It is also in the order of milliseconds only. So once again you connect here, it gets charged up, then you release like that. Okay, it all happens within a fraction of time, the charging and discharging. So you press, release, and there will be a response from the patient quickly. Then the heart starts functioning normally. So these are the things you have to know. Then we have two cases, and even before that, the energy stored in the capacitor, you all know, half CV square, that is the energy stored in the capacitor. And the time constant, I told you roughly it is RC, charging or discharging time. So we have two cases, directly to heart applied externally. Directly to heart means it is an open surgery kind of things, or you can that is direct. Applied externally, outside, you can without doing an opening the heart and all, you can apply this shock, but the required energy is 400 joules. Whereas for directly, when you apply this shock, then it needs only 50 to 100 joules. Okay, the energy here is very low, whereas it is 400 joules when you apply externally. If I say externally, means you have not done any operate, you have not operated the upper portion. Okay, so just you can give the shock over the skin. Okay, now we have two types of control. How to control the mechanism? What are the parameters we have in hand? One is the voltage across the capacitor. This voltage, that if you vary that, or if you increase the R value or decrease the R value, depends on that the voltage across the capacitor can be varied. So you all know that voltage across the capacitor VC is equal to V into 1 minus e power minus t by RC. So the voltage, this voltage controls the voltage across the capacitance, and the other parameter is small t and RC. RC is the time constant, I told you. So another parameter we have is the time. How long you want to charge or discharge. So these two parameters, time you can control, voltage across the capacitor in also can be controlled, or both can be controlled. So we have two types of defibrillator applications. One is monophasic. For this, 3 to 12 millisecond is the time. This can go from 3 millisecond to 12 millisecond. We have biphasic. In biphasic, we have positive pulse as well as negative pulse. Okay. So biphasic, if it is a positive pulse, it goes for 3 to 10 millisecond. If it is a negative pulse, it goes for 1 to 10 millisecond. So by this explanation, you know how the internal circuitry of a defibrillator works. The key component involved here is the capacitance, because you are making the capacitance charge and capacitance discharge. Also, you come to know what's the voltage required, time required, energy required for different cases. What is the area of the plates that is placed, that the electrode size, 9 cm into 9 cm approximately, so 81 cm square, and the resistance of the plates. The typical shock waveform given to the patient. Okay, and why we are using auto transformer. So these are the some of the points you have to keep in your mind. As far as plus two students is concerned, you have come across so many components by this explanation, but one key application you should know, that capacitor is being used. One of the application of the capacitor we have studied through this circuit explanation of defibrillator. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you for watching. Nandri.